Welcome to the Best of the Left Activism Update. My name is Lauren, and I'm the activism czar at bestoftheleft.com. Okay, ladies and feminist men, listen up. This GOP-produced war on women has gone too far. Well, to be fair, it went too far during the Republican primaries months ago, but has since escalated to a point of no return. You would think these men running the Republican show would have more common sense. I mean, women make up half the voting electorate. One would think they too desire equal rights and equal protection under the law for their mothers and sisters and wives and daughters. Well, guess again. We continue to live in a patriarchal world, and if you thought this war on women was limited to the nut-wing, radical right, fundamental Santorums and Perrys running for office, Mitt Romney is not as moderate as most of us have been led to believe. While he may appear as a bumbling, out-of-touch capitalist, superficially pandering to every base for electoral purposes, for instance, his then Massachusetts gubernatorial support of Planned Parenthood and gay rights, to his now contradictory current stump speeches where he articulates his stance against marriage equality and contraception. As a sidebar, for an excellent ideology on the war on women, we highly recommend Frank Rich's New York Magazine article, which we will link on the show notes. Inside, Rich articulates Romney's long history of personal patriarchal fundamentalism in his business practices, his Mormonism as bishop, and his private relationships. He is even behind shutting down Title X, the federally funded family planning program that supports many women's health initiatives, and has yet to say whether he supports equal pay for equal work. So back to the GOP. Let's recap what has transpired thus far. Since January, the Republicans have proposed redefining rape to only cases of, quote, forcible rape to deny access to women's health services, voted repeatedly to defund Planned Parenthood, held a hearing on women's health with 5 men and no women present, voted to give corporations the power to deny women access to contraception, and threatened to renew the once bipartisan Violence Against Women Act, then voted for a watered-down version that omits help for those who fall under immigrant and LGBT status. If you thought Rush Limbaugh attacking Sandra Fluke triggered an outrage in conservative mindsets, well, my friends, the only anger it evoked was that Limbaugh turned what was covertly being implemented into an overt exposé of the GOP gamebook. In other words, they weren't mad at what he said, but that he said it during an electoral year. And it is only escalating from here. Last week, 2 Michigan Democratic representatives, Lisa Brown and Barb Byram, were barred by the Republican-controlled Congress from a second day of speaking because, get this, they used, quote, inappropriate language when addressing the speaker. Their words, you asked? Vagina and vasectomy. As a feisty Dem brilliantly suggested on behalf of all lady parts, if you can't say it, you can't legislate it. These misogynists will do anything to silence our voice and our ability to choose what is right for us, our bodies, and our families. Being the best of the left female half, I'm pretty upset, and Jay is too. So let's get mad and then do something about it. First, we must support the progressive women representatives that are right now fighting this war inside state legislatures and in the Capitol. Now, I don't mean every woman is by nature progressive. Someone like Michelle Bachmann is no more a feminist than Larry Craig is a gay rights activist. Many women continue to be what I will call misogyny apologists. But we must support the women's voices who have real women's interests in mind. This occurred last week in Michigan when women from all over the country gathered outside the state building to read the Vagina Monologues as a playful and powerful demonstration of female power. Second, while it has come under so much attack and since there are multiple chapters in the country, let us do our part to support Planned Parenthood. Please go to Planned Parenthood's Action Center at PlannedParenthoodAction.org. Here you can learn all about the issues and directly get involved. Lastly, state by state, new disturbing bills are making their way through legislatures, like Virginia's mandatory transvaginal ultrasound requirement. Please go to UniteWomen.org to learn more about what's going on in your state and to take action. We are not going to sit back and politely take what these misogynists are implementing. We are progressive women, so as they say, hear us roar. This has been a passionately argued Best of the Left activism update. For more information about the links mentioned in this segment, please consult the show notes at bestoftheleft.com.